So module 3, we are going to discuss about cloud delivered firewall and rule and what are the monitor hit counts. We discuss DNS policy, and in DNS policy, we discuss that if there is a blacklisted, whitelisted domain. So based on that, it will perform the filtering or it can protect, right, your network.
Exactly.
And then apart from the DNS policy, the second one is the cloud delivered firewall in orders. So in cloud delivered firewall umbrellas, this is the umbrellas firewall policy, or we can say a kind of firewall working as a firewall. So cloud delivered firewall or CDFW that will provide visibility and control for internet traffic, that means outbound traffic across all branch offices. So the question is that here, when we are going to opt for the cloud delivered firewall, so what are the features provided and what are the requirements when you are going to set up the cloud delivered firewall? Because when you are going to set up the cloud delivered firewall, then there is some requirements we need to understand, like what are the device should be there, what data center you want to connect, right? Because we are making IPsec tunnel connections with the Cisco umbrella. So requirement, like we can say, obviously internet connection must be there for outbound IPsec tunnels. And umbrella account there should be for the cloud delivered firewall, or we can say license for the cloud delivered firewall services. And IPsec IK version 2 tunnel capable device, we must have, like maybe say Cisco ISR G2 and ISR 4000, 1000 virtual V, and ASA FTD, Meraki MX. So these are the devices should be there, right, sir? So there is some limit, like the number of tunnels you can implement through the cloud delivered firewall to connect to the Cisco umbrella, correct? So yesterday we talked about like how to register the device, okay? So we can have a different deployment and different options, like maybe this is our Cisco umbrella. We can say let's Cisco umbrella. This is our gateway. Yeah, and this could be any device, maybe Active Directory, DNS, and so on. And here. So either we can provide, this is private IP address, and here, 10.10.10.20. These are the private IP address and gateway here. So there is two cases. Either we can individually add all the machine inside the behind the gateway, like these are the two machines, like maybe ADDNS or maybe web servers or any. So either we can connect to the Cisco umbrella directly, we can put the DNS entries, right, sir?
Yes, okay. Exactly.
Or we can register this gateway and with the Cisco umbrella by providing a public IP address here. So that's a DNS policy we are talking about, like maybe we can say 208.67.222.222. So this way. This was the one method, but the problem is that in this case, if we are doing like this way netting, like all the system is behind this gateway and hidden, the policy is pushed by the Cisco umbrella to the gateway. And if the users try to access the resources, then they will be, translated into public IP address, and umbrella would not be able to get the complete reports about the clients, right? Which clients accessing what services? Umbrella will get the only single public IP address. It will find the traffic was initiated from these guys, right? So all IP address is hidden behind this public
exactly
address.
Exactly.
So that was
in the source and the clients, you have put the same IP address. Check this out.
Sorry, in what?
On the left side, where the DNS server web services are, on the left side, there is the same IP address. No, in the left.
Left, yeah, this one.
10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10.
No, it's wrong. That should be different IP, of course.
Different IP, 21 or whatever.
Maybe we can say different IP. So here, either there is two case here we can implement. We can implement DNS entries of the Cisco umbrella to each individual device, or we can put the DNS entry here. But the problem is that if we put here, then all the device will be represented with the single public IP address for the Cisco umbrella. Cisco umbrella will find, okay, this is always the traffic initiated from this public IP address, right? So it cannot track the information about these individual systems, right, sir?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, then what we can say, okay, no problem. We can put the DNS entries of these to each device. That is also the problem. Like we have to go to each device and define this public IP address to the Cisco umbrella directly, right? Either this is one case, but here we have seen last time, if we do this, then what happened that if a client will perform any request, then the clients, if it is internal, then it's okay. But if the client is connecting to the Cisco umbrella, its request is going in a clear text, right, sir?
Mm-hmm.
Let's say, I'm saying maybe this one is the client that if it is client machines, then what happened? Every time it will generate a DNS request. If it is local internal, I mean, it can connect to the local DNS servers. We can say this is the one case.
Away. Yeah.
Yeah. Straight away. You're right. Internal DNS server. Or if it is performing request to the external, maybe somewhere else, then this one we can say external.
Mm-hmm.
But in case of external DNS server, we found the problem is that the communication between this client and the servers here, maybe DNS servers over the internet. So the problem was that their information was in a clear text, right, sir? Clear text.
In a clear text.
That means information was not protected, encrypted. That's what we use virtual appliance.
Yeah, exactly. Right?
Okay, so then we introduce here virtual appliance here. So in that case, virtual appliance, the client request is going to the virtual appliance, and virtual appliance will find out. It will have information about local DNS server as well as external DNS servers. If the client request is going to the virtual, local DNS server, then virtual appliance will forward locally. But if your request is going to the external, then virtual appliance will record your IP address and username details, right?
Mm-hmm, exactly.
And based on that, it will send the request to the Cisco umbrella. So what happened in this case, Cisco umbrella will have information about your IP address, your user and authentication process and all, like similar to single sign-on and passkey authentication, which we discussed yesterday, right, sir?
Mm-hmm.
But here, there is another way we can implement this because we were doing manually, we are using virtual plans here. And also we are installing a roaming clients, Cisco AnyConnect roaming client on these machines to perform this kind of activity, so that information of users and IP address will be tracked to the Cisco umbrella. So another solution that apart from the DNS, because this one is a completely DNS policy. Second one, support a firewall policy. Firewall policy, that means it is just similar to your on-premises based appliance like firewall. And but the thing is that here in firewall policy, in Cisco umbrella, this term, this is defined as a CDFW, cloud delivered firewall. Cloud delivered firewall. So in cloud delivered firewall, what it says, so there is some requirements, and based on that requirements, you can configure your device. Let's say there you have ASA firewall, or maybe FTD you have, or maybe ISR routers. Okay, so ISR 4000s. So any of the device maybe you have, and then you want to connect these devices to the Cisco umbrella. So here is saying, when you are connecting from this device to the Cisco umbrella, then to secure the connections, there is IPsec tunnel, you know, provided. So here is IPsec tunnel.
So the IPsec tunnel must be from the firewall.
Yes, exactly, sir. From the firewall to the Cisco umbrella, sir. Yes, sir. So that means everything will be, you know, in protected, of course, encrypted, because there is a dedicated tunnel. So there is a different data centers provided by the Cisco umbrella. Okay, and in that data center, they have routers, device, so that you can connect to those routers from your on-premises device, like ASA FTD or ISR 4000. So that's what I was talking about, the requirement for this one, like, of course, but internet connection.
Yeah, all the devices must be from Cisco, or we can do it from
Meraki, Meraki,
for example. Yes.
Right now, currently, actually, I have seen that Cisco ISR routers 4000, 1000, ASA, FTD, Meraki, Viptela, VH, and CH. But other devices vendor, you know, is still considering. I mean, they are working on it, Cisco umbrella. Right now, I have not seen that, sir. Okay. I don't have information, sir. Right, sir. Okay, sir. Can you proceed? So, okay, internet connections, and then umbrella CDFW account should be there, plus IPsec. IPsec, it support IKE version 2. Actually, there is two, IPsec tunnel, protocol, yeah. IKE version 1 and IKE version 2. IKE version 2 is the most secure. This one is using. And plus, also, we can say, device, already I said that there is some dedicated device supported IPsec tunnel device, and then, you know, one more thing, like maybe there is a firewall between this Cisco umbrella or ASA, or maybe this ISR 4000 router we have for ISR G2 routers, and between them there is a firewall. Then that means IPsec protocols like UDP port 500 and UDP port 4500 must be allowed. Right, sir?
Mm-hmm.
So these are some requirements when we are going to set up and umbrella organization ID. These are the requirements. So actions, what we can define actions here. Action can be block or allow, and the rule we can define. The rule includes the we can say application layer or layer 7. we can create a rule for the application layer. Maybe we can say Facebook, you know, messengers, audio, video, etc. Source tunnel we can define based on the source tunnel, because we are working on tunnel. Source tunnel, source port, that means which ports you want to monitor. Source port and source CIDR. And also destination ports, we can say port and CIDR, and of course time zone. So we can define rule based on the time. So these are the, you know, in firewall policy or cloud delivered firewall policy. So these are the requirement, and these things we can do. Layer 7 filtering source tunnel based on the source, based on the source port and destination port, we can filter. And also it can create a firewall rule settings. So for web application requests, even the web traffic is coming, okay, across the let's say there is a web traffic is coming across this firewall, then firewall will just go be the as per the firewall policy. First it will try to look for the application, which application you are going to protect, filter, and what is the source tunnel, what is the destination port, and what is the source port. Apart from that, if there is some web request is generated, and then what it will do, it will try to just filter through the firewall policy. If it is not matching, then web policy, because we have already discussed the firewall, I mean the Cisco umbrella will first contact the DNS, then second cloud delivered firewall. And if that traffic is not matching with the cloud delivered firewall or firewall policy, then the web policy, right, sir? So this one. So when it will create a firewall rule setting in this is cloud delivered firewall for web application request. So umbrella applies this, you know, there is a sequence check, like I just said, this one. Let's say here, for example, umbrella first check firewall rule as for identity and destination. Umbrella first check firewall rule as through the cloud delivered firewall policy, that what is the destination, identity and destination based on that. If matched, then rule defines what a block actions, maybe block actions. So if it is block, let's say CDW blocks the request. So umbrella first will match a rule against the identity and destination. If the matching rule defines a block actions, then CDFW cloud delivered firewall will do what? It will block the request, or we can say if matched traffic rule defines allow action, then So this is the key point I want to just focus. So if it is blocks, then simply cloud delivered firewall, I mean the firewall policy will block as per the orders, like number one, DNS cloud delivered, we are working here cloud delivered firewall. So if the rule is matching block, then it will take action. But if the rule is allow for the web traffic, then the traffic will be forwarded or redirected to the web policy, okay, against the secure web gateway, so that the check will be performed there, right, sir? So cloud delivered firewall automatically forward, so that means the conclusion is that cloud delivered firewall automatically forward HTTPS traffic on port 80 or 443 to the umbrella. So simply we can say HTTP or HTTPS traffic forwarded to SWG so here let's go with details. Full traffic processing, we have discussed this already, like proxies in different policy through the DNS, that was and here policy through the DNS and firewall and full proxy. So DNS is the first one, second one is the firewall policy or cloud delivered firewall, where we need IPsec tunnel, and the finally full proxy, or we can say there is an intelligent proxy, secure web gateway simply. So key requirement for the cloud delivered firewall services, that means full logging and statistics. So it will maintain the complete logging, layer 3 to layer 4 port and protocol protection. But of course, layer 7 inspection is there for the application visibility control, which we discussed, like maybe you want to allow Facebook, but nobody can play the game and chat and so on. Time-based, we can define a policy based on the time and larger tunnel capacity. So up to the 50 tunnels at a time it can support, right, sir? And IPS and IDS inspections we can also enable with the cloud delivered services. So cloud delivered firewall provide firewall functionality at the cloud edge and protection at the first hop for direct internet access, branch office and guest network. Ability to enforce beyond DNS across all port and protocols, and currently layer 3 to layer 4. Okay, so now expanding to layer 7 as well, and more advanced functionality, guest network gets NAT behind a Cisco IP address in the cloud rather than enterprise IP address. So now here you can see if we are not using DNS policy in the default first line of the defense DNS policy, then directly cloud delivered firewall with these devices and then secure web gateway for the HTTP and HTTPS traffic. Firewall policy here, there is a different firewall policy they have defined here. In Cisco umbrella, order of the operation is the same as with ACL, top to bottom approach is matching. Cloud delivered firewall rules. So there is a different sections we can find it here. So where it will define the firewall rule based on the protocols. So protocol to which the rule applies, options, maybe you can say TCP, UDP and ICMP or any you will find here. So there is a different port and protocols. Second thing is that applications. So application and app categories where you can define to which the rule applies. So here that is called app categories or applications. Second thing is that source tunnel to which the rule applies. I mean, maybe you can have multiple tunnel and on which source tunnel you are going to create a rule. So search for tunnel to add them, and up to 3 tunnels are displayed dynamically as you begin entry text. So, but I said 50 tunnel you can set up but on the Cisco umbrella, but when you create a policy, then when you search, then it is showing 3 characters. Three tunnels at a time, plus a source IP and source port you can define. Source IP you can define here, or complete particular IP address, or complete classless inter-domain routing, or complete subnet we can define to which the rule applies in a plain text list, and delimited by commas or any values. Second one is the source IP, source ports. So source port, the same to which the rule applies in a plain text list, you know, you can define delimited by commas or any value. So here in this box, you can define source port, destination IPs and destination ports. So based on these criteria, we can define a rule in cloud delivered firewall. And this is the time zone we can define for how long, I mean, this rule will be valid, from what time and date you can define a start and a start, you know, expiration time, right, sir?
Mm-hmm.
Now, cloud delivered firewall monitor hit counts. The firewall policy hit count is the number of times a firewall rule has been invoked, as well as the most recent invocation time. If logging is disabled for a given policy, the hit count for that policy, of course, it will be disabled. Cloud delivered firewall reporting provide context and filtering. Context means what? Context, we can say it's a rich set of logging, like, you know, context, we can say a kind of 360 degree, similar to that 360 degree. That means you can get the information from who is going to access, what going to access, how long they are connected, which source IP, destination IP. So there is many information is, you know, combined into one log or event that is called context. So you can see there is identity, ASA, new identity type, cloud delivered file, destinations, this one, internal IP or external IP, action allowed or blocked. So all these information is combined into one event, and that is called context. And here there's a filtering you can do based on the specific events. Like, let's say you want to get all the event if it is going to the destination IP 8.8.8.8 and for the DNS request. So we can create search, and that means based on what criteria you want to look for the event. Umbrella cloud delivered firewall. Yes, we will do this. I think solving shadow IT challenges. So, sir, I just want to know that what is the shadow IT challenge? What is the shadow IT?
Shadow IT. I have no idea.
Okay, so actually shadow IT, basically that is part of software as a service application activity, where actually it is the use of information technology system, you know, and IT, mostly this used by the IT departments and as an information technology system on devices, we can say, or software and application for all purposes we can use, and services without explicit IT department approval. So behind their, network topology, or maybe in servers, they are having another kind of servers and they are getting information from there. So services that will be, you know, explicitly IT department without IT department approval, and workers adopt new technology that help them do their jobs faster and achieve better results. And it has grown exponentially in recent years with the adoption of the cloud-based application and services. And that's what I say, cloud software as a services. So shadow IT discovery will provide you the ability to identify cloud application uses by using the firewall or proxy logs, and to provide risk assessment or risk evaluation for those discovered application. Right, sir? Now, application visibility and control. Here, DNS versus secure web gateway. If you talk about platform visibility and control, in DNS, it will provide the reliable visibility and into apps uses. In secure web gateway, it will provide additional attributes like bandwidth congestions, data traversing applications, data exposures, by using the secure web gateway. Control features, DNS can only block or allow at domain level. So here the limitation in the DNS, we discussed already that based on the whitelist and blacklist, but secure web gateway provide advanced application control, more accurate blocking and allowing activity controls such as blocking, uploads, download, which we can say file type control. like what types of file will be allowed to be uploaded or downloaded, email attachment or social post, whether you are allowed to do or not, right? So that's what this will provide a little bit more features than the DNS one, Secure Web Gateway.